السلام عليكم، صباح الخير. رجعنا لكم عن جديد بس هالمرة عن بعد. إن شاء الله تمر الفترة على خير وبنرجع لمحاضراتنا. حنصير ناخذ المحاضرات أونلاين. المحاضرات حتكون مسجلة وإن شاء الله بحطيكم كل التعليمات كيف حيتم التواصل. طبعاً حتكون عن طريق اللايف شات. حأعملكم فيديو منفصل أوضح لكم فيه كيف حيتم التواصل وحيتم الاستفسارات من قبلكم عن طريق المول. طيب، هذا السكشن احنا وصلنا لهذا السكشن قبل الإجازة، قبل فترة الطوارئ، وأعتقد أني أنا ماشي فيه كويس، بس لأنه كان آخر محاضرة الحضور قليل فحعيده very quickly. okay. So احنا وصلنا ل section 16.7 relative motion analysis. هالمره راح نحكي عن acceleration. As a reminder, section 16.4 and 5 and 6 talked about velocity with different techniques. So section 16.4 كان بيحكي عن velocity but using absolute analysis method, or section 16.5 كمان الـ velocity using a relative اللي هي نفس هاي الطريقة motion analysis. Section 16.6 كان بيحكي عن الـ IC method. Now we'll move to acceleration. Okay, so the objective is the objective is to resolve the acceleration of a point on a body into components of translation and rotation. زي ما انتم عارفين الاكسلريشن له two component, especially اذا كان الميكانيزم بتعمل ايش، تعمل general plane motion. okay. so الاكسلريشن حيكون as a result for a point الها translation and rotation. So, حنشوفهم هدول. This is one objective. The other objective is to determine the acceleration of a point on a body by using relative acceleration analysis. واللي هي هذه التكنيك related لهذا السكشن. Application, I leave it for you. حتشوفوا، حتدوروا طبعا على اللينك اللي بيعمل general plane motion. زي ما انتم لاحظين هذا اللينك نقطة عليه بتعمل سلايد، والنقطة الثانية بتعمل روتيشن. okay. النقطة اللي بتعمل روتيشن حتتحلل لتانجنشال وحتتحلل لنورمال، لأنه نقطة تثبيت هذا اللينك inside here. okay. so بما أنه اللينك هذا بيدور حوالين هذه النقطة، معناته النقطة A حيكون في لها نورمال توارد نقطة التثبيت، والاتجاه الثاني الأكسلريشن حيكون تانجنت على الدائرة اللي بعملها هذا اللينك. Okay. So I leave it for you. Here the same. هذا هو اللينك اللي بيعمل general plane motion. هذا اللينك مثبت about A. Okay. So اللينك اللي بيعمل general plane motion اللي هو اللينك B. Let me call this one O. Okay. So B O هو اللي بيعمل general plane motion. So the equation relating the acceleration of two points on the body is determined by differentiating velocity equation. So عشان نبدأ بهذه الطريقة relative motion analysis، حنبدأ من عند ال velocity acceleration وحنشتقها with respect to time. So المعادلة اللي كانت عندنا في السابق vb تساوي va plus vb with respect to هذه relative velocity. Now if we derive it with respect to time، زي ما حكينا من قبل vb هي ال absolute velocity وال va absolute velocity، ال vb with respect to a هذه relative velocity. okay. now if we derive it with respect to time، ال absolute velocity derived with respect to time this one and this one، حيصير اسمهم ايش، absolute acceleration. okay. of a and b بنفس الطريقة absolute velocity absolute acceleration in the second with respect to now dvb with respect to a derived with respect to time. This term is acceleration of b with respect to a, and it includes both tangential and normal. So this inside tangential and normal embedded inside this component. So the result is our two components at all, absolute acceleration, okay, and inside this differentiation حيطلع معانا tangential, حيطلع معانا normal, both of them relative acceleration, one tangential and the other is normal. Okay, here is drawing. So بشرح لنا في البداية هذا الجسم بعمل general plane motion, okay, حنجزه حسب المعادلة. أول term absolute acceleration, so في البداية تحرك translation, okay, بعديها around point A عمل rotation, so هذا term مسؤول عن rotation. So the relative tangential acceleration component, acceleration B with respect to A tangential, احنا صرنا already عارفين المعادلة اللي هي alpha cross product ال relative position component R B with respect to A. هلا هذا الاتجاه تبعه as a magnitude alpha cross product R B with respect to A, as a direction it is perpendicular to R B with respect to A. Sorry. So this is the magnitude and direction. Direction زي ما احنا شايفين perpendicular على مين؟ على ال R B with respect to A. Now the relative normal acceleration component has a magnitude minus omega squared R B وبينهم dot product. Okay, so بينهم dot product. هذا الترم احنا بنعرف انه فيكتور بس بهذه الحالة لانه squared this is scalar. Okay, so زي ما انت شايفين هذه not bold this is bold. Okay, ال R B with respect to A bold, this is vector and this is scalar. So دائما حاصل ضرب هدول بعطيني نفس الدايركشن ل R B with respect to A. والدايركشن لإلها زي ما احنا عارفين تورد from B تورد A. Okay, زي ما احنا حكينا هذه نقطة بداية وهذه نقطة. Okay, so the direction is always from B لنقطة التثبيت اللي هي A. As a result, الإكواجن دائما حنكتبها بهذه الطريقة لذينك بعمل general plane motion. Okay, so AB تساوي AA absolute acceleration alpha cross product RB, ودائما الترتيب مهم alpha then cross product RB with respect to A minus omega squared RB with respect to A. وهنا بنرجع بنأكد last term is not cross product, it is dot product. Okay. Now بهمنا كثير وإحنا بنحل نعرف الاتجاهات أو نحاول نتنبأ فيهم. فمثلا هذه الميكانيزم A to B, so إذا هذا اللينك بيلف clockwise, okay, then النقطة اللي على B إلها velocity tangential وكمان إلها tangential acceleration. Okay, tangential acceleration as well. وكمان إلها normal acceleration. So المحصلة وين بتكون؟ المحصلة بتكون يعني somewhere here. Yes, like this one. Okay. So دائما بنروح قبل لا نروح لللينك اللي بيعمل general plane motion بهذه الحالة اللي هو اللينك ABC. Okay. So بهذه الحالة yes. بهذه الحالة اللي هو اللينك بي سي هو اللي بيعمل جنرال بلين موشن. اوكي، قبل لا نروح له بنشوف الجوينت اللي عليه كيف اتجاهاته. فهذه النقطة بي بسهولة جدا بقدر اعرف انه الريزلتنت اكسلريشن بهذا الاتجاه وباخذها I will take it and put it for the targeted link. اوكي، هلا البوينت سي هي بتعمل ترانزليشن لانه بلف بهذا الاتجاه فهي راح تروح toward right. Okay, so هيني عرفت كمان اتجاه. So دائما لما باجي بحل لازم اكون عارف الاتجاهات. So in applying the relative acceleration equation, the two points used in the analysis should generally, بشكل عام مش دائما في بعض الاحيان ما تزبط, be selected as a point which have a known motion. Okay, such as bin اللي هم النقاط التثبيت النهائية B, C بهذا الحال. Okay, so هذه الحكي حكيناها. الاتجاهي. البروسيجر فور سولفينج زي العاده, من اول شيء بنحدد الكوردينات بوزيتيف نيجاتيف دايركشن اوف روتيشن, وبعديها بنروح بنرسم الكينيماتيك دايجرام. انديكيت طبعا على الكينيماتيك دايجرام بروح بحدد كل المعلومات المتوفره عندي. اوكي, احيانا بتكون الابسوليوت فيلوسيتيز كمان لها تانجنشال ونورمال. اوكي, سو بدنا ننتبه عليها ونضيفهم على المعادله. سو هذه بنعوضها انسايد هير, اند ذس وان بنعوضها انسايد هير. اوكي, بلس ريلاتيف كومبوننتس. هلا كالعاده اذا كان النيجاتيف انسر معناها عكس القاضي. خلينا نشوف سؤال. بهذا السؤال, at the instance shown end A of the rod, okay, so at the instance shown, what's the case, end A, this one, what a point, has a velocity and acceleration shown, determine the angular acceleration of the rod. Angular acceleration of the rod means alpha A B. Okay, this is the first unknown. No, this is question. And acceleration of the end B. Acceleration of end B, you can tell easily that this point will move in this direction. So we need to find out acceleration of B. Okay, now I think I have correct answers. So let us move, determine. So let me draw for you the link. So this is A. And here we have B, okay, here is the positive directions, this is X, here we have Y, and this is the positive direction. So, point A, everything is given, so VA given, and acceleration A again given. Now, we need to find out the alpha. Let us assume that this is the rotation for alpha as well as for omega. Let's see, and why we need omega. Okay, so as you came to know that acceleration for point B will move in this direction. So AB is an okay. Now, how to solve? So first, we'll start with writing the equation. So AB equal AA plus alpha cross product RB plus A minus omega squared for the rod. You can name it AB, whatever you want to write it, dot product. Now, AB, we know the direction of AB, which is to the positive x-axis, but acceleration A to the negative j. So we'll write here the following. So AB, positive x, so this is A, B, positive y direction, equal AA negative AA J direction plus alpha, we assume it clock or counter. This is clockwise, okay? So we'll substitute it. We'll substitute it minus alpha K direction cross product. Now about the directions, Let me go back to the question. So here is the direction. Here we have 4, and the this is in the x and the y direction, and here unknown distance. But you can tell easily from Pythagoras that we name it x equal pi squared minus 4 squared, both of them under root square, and this is equal to 3. So here x equal to 3. So in the let me show the task bar. So here in the equation, we'll start from A and we'll end up with B. So if we go back to the question, we'll start from A and we'll end up with B. So if I want to move from A to B, first I should go in the negative y direction, minus 4. And then we'll move plus 3. Okay? Negative j direction, then positive I direction. So let us go back here. So this is first, we'll go in the negative direction of j. So this is minus 4 in j direction plus 3 in I direction. Okay? Now, minus omega squared, no need to substitute direction, only the magnitude of omega, but unfortunately we don't have omega, so I write it as this. We'll figure out that later how to write it. Dot product, we'll write the same equation, so 4 in j direction plus 3 in the I direction. So this equation, in this equation, there are three unknowns. AB is unknown. Okay, alpha again is unknown. And omega unknown. So we have two equations because this is I and J. I can't say this is two equations, but with the three unknowns. So what to do? Yes, correct. We must go back to the velocity equation. Yes, velocity equation. So in the velocity equation, dB equal dA plus dB with respect to A. And this is equal dA plus omega cross product R B with respect to A. So dB, we can tell that dB will move in the positive pi direction. Okay, and this is equal VA in the negative G direction, which is equal to minus, you can go back to the statement of the question, minus 6 in the J direction plus omega, we assume it clockwise, then I write minus, so minus omega, which is unknown, cross product. I will write the same equation, which is 3i minus 4j. Now, we'll do cross product. Okay, so VB the I direction equal to minus 6j minus, don't forget to add the k direction. Okay, so k cross product I, j positive and we have negative, so it remains negative, so minus 3 omega in j direction. Now negative with negative, positive. Okay, k cross product j, this is negative again, so it will remain negative 4 forming a I direction. So here, obviously, we have two equations. One equation in I direction, and the other equation in J direction. So let me start with the J direction. So J equation. In the left side, we have nothing, 0 equal to minus 6 plus 3 omega, so then omega equal to 6 to the other side, and positive 6 over 3 equal to rad second, and the p sign is positive, that means our assumption is correct. Okay. Now, once we know the magnitude of the omega, then we can go back to the acceleration equation. So AB will move as we mentioned. Will move in the positive I direction. So this is AB I equal to minus, but acceleration phi is given, so this is minus 5j plus or negative, we said, alpha k direction cross product 3 in the I direction minus 4 in j direction. Now we write minus 3 k direction cross product or dot, sorry, and no need to write the direction as well. Yes, so this is squared cross product or dot product, sorry, 3 in the I direction minus 4 in J direction. And this is equal. Let me change the color. Okay, so I did the mistake here. So omega equal minus 2 squared. Okay, then AB equal to minus 5J minus, so k cross product I, this is j, so minus 3 omega j, minus with minus positive k, this is negative 4 alpha I direction, minus, this is 4 dot product 3, this is 12 I direction, minus with minus positive, this is 16J. Okay, now we have two equations. I'll start with the J equation. So on the left side we have nothing. 0 equal to minus 5 plus or minus 3. 3 alpha plus 16, if you calculate it, you find that alpha equal to, this is minus 16, and so this is plus. Now we'll move to the I equation. In the I equation we have AB equal to, what do we have here? We have minus 4 alpha, minus 2. So minus 4 alpha minus 12, and this is equal to minus 26.164 meter per second squared. And the direction, it means we have a deceleration. So that's it for this lecture. We'll continue this section in the coming videos. Thank you for listening.